Often I get questions about what 3D programs we use to run our animation productions successfully, and what makes us efficient. Now, it's a valid question, but I would just like to make some correction over here, because there is a lot more than just a 3D program that is required to get through the complex planning of creative project. Now, what you see on the screen are great visual sequences that are visualized by great artists with the use of greater technology. But behind every great piece of work is a lot of research, thinking, and planning, which is often messy and unstructured at early stages and takes time to evolve. Which is why having the right tools for your day-to-day design needs is very crucial, be it planning, production, or management, especially when you're dealing with animation and motion design, because there are several processes that need to run parallel in sync for creative tasks and planning. There are various kinds of projects that we deal with, which includes making animated TV commercials, game trailers, brand idents, motion graphics, and sometimes we also make our own short films. My workflow requires a very flexible canvas where I can just map my thoughts without any limits, whatever comes to my mind. Now, at the early stage of creative process, everything is like a piece of puzzle that needs to be solved. And this puzzle is broken into several pieces. One of these pieces could be an image that reminds you of something, or maybe a dialogue that inspires the narrative of your story, a bird that inspires the color of the theme. Now, these pieces don't make much sense when you look at them individually, but if you combine them, they can seed your next big idea. Crafting an animated product is a big challenge in itself. As much as I enjoy my daily creative routine, keep in mind this process can get messy if you're not using the right tools for planning of your projects and organizing your stuff. That also means it can limit your creativity. And just the other day we were discussing how important it is being resourceful and being aware of the right tools that can take care of your daily design needs and help free up more mind space so you can focus more on the creative aspect of the project. So today we are going to have a look at one new tool that I came across recently, which I found very simple, intuitive, and useful. It kind of reminds me of brainstorming ideas on big studio wall with just the notes and images. Meet Milanote, the tool for organizing your creative projects. It's a tool that lets you put your thoughts in any visual format you would need on a virtually endless canvas, be it captions, images, videos, fonts, color palettes, checklists, notes, emojis, storyboards, 3D model previews. It's simple, and that's what makes it flexible. Like a sticky note, it becomes what you draw on it, and that's what makes it multipurpose. Whenever I have a new idea about a project, I can start by creating a new board, bring in the thoughts and information I have about the project, drop it on the board, and just map it out. It's as simple as that. Add my team so we can collaborate on it. Now, this is just the beginning. Soon I'll have more ideas from my team which are added to the same boards. I can give feedback to my team within these boards with the comments and arrows, and also can throw in few more visual inspirations if I'd like to. I can also replace the images with my own sketches. I can keep on adding boards throughout the different phases of the projects. Now, just to give you an example, let's say you have an idea about an animation that you want to make, but you're not sure where to begin and you are brainstorming about different pieces of your idea. You might have several things that inspire you, but you're not sure what to do with it. So you can start by creating a new board and give it a name that you would like, and it will auto-generate an icon depending on the name that you have chosen. You can also replace it with a custom image or icon that you would prefer. Now, just drop in whatever thoughts you have in your mind and media that inspires your thoughts and animation. And these could be image files from your computer, links from the web, videos from the Vimeo, YouTube, or any other video platform, 3D models from the Sketchfab, fonts if you're making a title sequence of some sort. And you can do that in several ways. You can just copy and paste it, drag and drop it, click and upload it. It's very interactive, and it picks up the best visual format for whatever you are bringing on the board. Now you can sort this out and make a nice layout for yourself, which clears out the clutter and gives you a visual harmony. Or you can choose a layout from plenty of presets, which I find very fascinating. And soon you will see a board, which is a good starting point to build over. It's like a creative brief that tells you what you need to do with inspiration, constraints, etc., all mapped out in front of you. Now you can add your team or colleagues you want to collaborate with, even friends, just to know their thoughts. Or you can also make a board public if you are dealing with an open source project. Just type out their emails and this will send them an invitation to collaborate for the board. It's like we are sitting on the same table and brainstorming. I can see the content uploaded by other members and their comments, reactions, all updating at the same time. Soon we add more boards to this for different production phases, so I will add more boards and map them out in sequence. Starting from the script, then storyboard, animatic, mood board, style frames, character design, whatever suits your creative process. And there is just no limit to it. And these boards will keep on populating with content as we proceed further from the different stages of the production. So here I have a storyboard that I would like to add here. I will just drag and drop all the sketches to the board, sequence them, and add captions and all the detail related to the shots in the captions. And when I get storyboards from my colleagues, it's very easy to give feedback. I can just shuffle boards if I need to, replace images with my own sketches, or just throw in a few visual references. Similarly, we have different boards for style frames, which is being worked on simultaneously by other members. Soon you will see your simple boards evolving and inspiring your next thoughts and becoming something big and complete. So I'm sure many of you watching my channel today have many plans for the future. Maybe you want to make your own short films or comic book or something you have been planning for very long. So what you can do is make a board today and start typing your thoughts. Add some visuals, add some videos or any sketches you have done in the past when you were brainstorming this idea, and bring all that information in one board. And this first action may lead you to a plan of action you have been waiting for long. And it's not just about animation. Even if you're working on your website, your portfolio, you can use these simple tools in smart ways and plan out many different things within these boards. So don't go for my word. Try it out for yourself. You can use it for free. Link is in the description, and you can just sign up easily. And there should be a plenty of space in the free plan for you to explore for your personal projects. Try it out and let me know if you come up with a new technique for Milanote. I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a good day. Bye.